Welcome to my channel. Today in this video, I have come up with a very beautiful flower pattern which can be used as a coaster, as a pot holder, as a hot pad, or even as a mini doily for table area. The methods that I have applied in this project is double crochet, chains, single crochet, half double crochet. So this project is very good for the beginners to learn about all these methods. It is very easy to make and even a beginner can try to make it. So we are going to begin now. Things that we require for the project are yarn of 4 colors. The choice of colors depend on you. A pair of scissors to use as and when required and a hook that could match to the thickness of the yarn. I am going to use a hook of 9 mm. So let's get started. To begin the pattern, take the tail of the yarn of color A, make a loop, insert the hook in, pull through to make a slip knot. Now wrap the yarn on your hook, pull through, pull through, pull through, and pull through. These are 4 chains. We have to insert the hook into the 4th chain. Pull through. Now there are 2 loops on the hook. Pull through both the loops. This is slip stitch. The foundation ring is ready. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet. Chain 1 for chain space. Wrap the yarn on your hook. Insert the hook into the ring. Pull through. There are 3 loops on the hook. Pull through 2. Pull through 2. This is double crochet. Chain 1 for chain space. Now wrap the yarn on your hook. Insert the hook into the ring. Pull through. Pull through 2. Pull through 2. This is third double crochet. Now chain 1 for chain space. We have to complete 12 double crochet into the ring with chain space of 1. So complete the round by making 12 double crochet. And we'll meet again when this round would be completed. When these 12 double crochet into the ring are complete, we have to make chain 1 and now we have to join the stitches into the 4th, 2nd, 3rd chain of the 4th stitch with a slip stitch. Now we have to cut the yarn because we are going to add color B to the pattern. To add color B, take the tail of the yarn, make a loop, insert the hook in, pull through to make a slip knot. Now we have to join the yarn into the chain space of 1. So insert the hook in, pull through. There are 2 loops on the hook, pull through both the loops. This is slip stitch. We have joined the yarn into the chain space of 1 with a slip stitch. Now chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet, and into the chain space of 1, insert the hook in, pull through 2, pull through 2. So these are 2 double crochet into the chain space of 1. Chain 1 for chain space. Into the next chain space of 1, we have to make double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Chain 1 for chain space. Into the next chain space of 1, we have to make double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Again, chain space of 1. So complete the round by making 2 double crochet into each chain space of 1, and there should be chain space of 1 in between 2 clusters of double crochet. Complete the round and we'll meet again when this round would be completed. When this round is complete, you can see that we have made 2 double crochet into each chain space of 1 and we have made a chain in between each cluster of double crochet. Now when the round is complete, we have to make chain 1 and now we have to join the stitches into the 4th, 2nd, 3rd chain of the 4th stitch with a slip stitch. Now we have to cut the yarn from here because we are going to add color C to the pattern. To add color C, take the tail of the yarn, make a loop, insert the hook in, pull through to make a slip knot. Now into the chain space of 1. Insert the hook in, pull through. There are 2 loops on the hook. Pull through 2. This is slip stitch. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet, and into the same chain space of 1, we have to make a double crochet. Now, without making any chains in between, we have to make 1 double crochet in between these 2 stitches. Again, into the chain space of 1, we have to make 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. Now, in between 2 double crochet, we have to make 1 double crochet. Into the next chain space of 2, we have to make double crochet 1 and double crochet 2. So we have to complete the round by making 2 double crochet into each chain space of 1, and in between 2 double crochet we have to make 1 double crochet. So complete the round and we'll meet again when this round would be complete. When this round is complete, we have to join the stitches into the 4th, 2nd, 3rd chain of the 4th stitch with a slip stitch. Now we have to cut the yarn from here because we are going to add color D to the pattern. To add color D, once again we have to make a loop, insert the hook in, pull through to make a slip knot. Now we have to begin the round with this stitch where we have made 1 double crochet. So insert the hook on the top of the stitch, pull through 2 to make a slip stitch. Now on the top of the next stitch where we have made 2 double crochet into chain space of 1, we have to wrap the yarn on the hook, pull through. Now there are 3 loops on the hook, pull through all the 3 loops. This is half double crochet. Again on the top of next double crochet we have to make a double crochet. On the top of one crochet we have to make double crochet 1, into the same stitch double crochet 2, into the same stitch double crochet 3. Now wrap the yarn on your hook. On the top of the next stitch where we have made 2 double crochet into chain space of 1, we have to make a double crochet. Now on the top of the next stitch a half double crochet, and into the next stitch a single crochet. Again on the top of the next stitch we have to make a half double crochet, on the top of the next stitch a double crochet. Now we have come to the stitch where we have made 1 double crochet. On the top of this stitch we have to make 3 double crochet into the same stitch. 1, 2 and 3rd double crochet into the same stitch. Now on the top of the next stitch where we have made 2 double crochet into chain space of 1, we have to make a double crochet. Now on the top of the next stitch a half double crochet, and on the top of the stitch where we have made 1 double crochet a single crochet. Now on the top of the next stitch we have to make a half double crochet, on the top of the next a double crochet, and now we have come to the stitch where we have made a single double crochet, where we have to make double crochet 1, 2, and 3 into the same stitch. Now on the top of next stitch we have to make a double crochet, on the top of the next a half double crochet, on the top of the next stitch a single crochet, on the top of the next there are 3 loops on the hook, pull through all the 3 loops. On the top of the next we have to make a double crochet, on the top of the next stitch where we have made single double crochet we have to make 3 double crochet into the same stitch. So 1, 2, and 3. So this is going to be the base of the flower. I am going to explain about the stitches once again. We have to begin the pattern from the single double crochet with a single crochet or the slip stitch. Into the next stitch we have to make a half double crochet. On the top of the next double crochet we have to make a double crochet, and when we will reach where we have made single double crochet we have to make 3 double crochet on the top of the same stitch. Again a double crochet, a half double crochet, a single crochet, a half double crochet, and on the top of the next stitch a double crochet, on the top of the next 3 double crochet into the same stitch, a double crochet, a half double, a single crochet, a half double. So complete the round following the same pattern, and at the end of the round there should be 6 petals across the round. When the round is complete we have to join the stitches on into the single crochet with a slip stitch. Now on the top of the next stitch wrap the yarn on your hook, insert the hook into the next stitch, pull through all the 3. This is half double crochet. Wrap the yarn on your hook, insert the hook on the top of the next stitch, pull through all the 3. This is half double crochet. Now on the top of the next stitch we have to make a double crochet. Now we have come to the point where we have made 3 double crochet into the same stitch. So on the top of the 4th stitch we have to make double crochet 1, 2, and 3 into the same stitch. Now on the top of the next stitch we have to make double crochet 1, 2, and 3 into the same stitch. On the top of the next stitch we have to make single double crochet. So wrap the yarn on your hook, pull through two. On the top of the next stitch we have to make a half double crochet, on the top of the next a half double crochet. Now on the top of the single crochet we have to make single crochet, on the top of the next stitch a half double crochet, on the top of the next a double crochet. Now on the top of the next stitch 3 double crochet, on the top of the same stitch, on the top of the next stitch 3 double crochet 1, 2, and 3 into the same stitch. This is going to be the peak for the flower. Now for the valley we have to make a double crochet, on the top of the next stitch a half double crochet, on the top of the next a half double crochet, and on the top of the single crochet we have to make a single crochet, on the top of the next stitch a half double crochet, on the top of the next a half double crochet, on the top of the next a double crochet. Now we have come to the point where we have to make the peak for the flower. So in between 2 double crochet we have to make double crochet 1, 2, and 3 into the same stitch. Again, on the top of the next stitch, we have to make double crochet 1, 2, and 3 on the top of the same stitch. Again, a double crochet on the top of the next stitch, a half double crochet, a half double crochet again on the top of single crochet, make a single crochet. Now I am going to explain how to make the peak and valley of the flower. So we have to begin the pattern by making a slip stitch on the single crochet. Into the next stitch we have to make a half double crochet, into the next a half double crochet. So after a single crochet we have to make 2 half double crochet, a double crochet. Then we will reach at the point where we have made 3 double crochet in the previous round. In between 2 stitches we have to make 3 double crochet, and in between 2 stitches again we have to make 3 double crochet for the peak of the flower. Now for the valley, we have to make a double crochet into the next stitch, 2 half double crochet, on the top of the single crochet a single crochet. Again we have to make 2 half double crochet, a double crochet, 3 double crochet in between 2 stitches, and 3 double crochet in between 2 stitches where we have made 3 double crochet in the previous round. Again a double crochet, 2 half double crochet, and a single crochet for the valley of the petal. So complete the round following the same pattern, and we'll meet again when this round would be completed. When the round is complete, the pattern would appear something like this, and this is looking so very beautiful for the table mat, and I'm sure that you are going to love this pattern. If you like the pattern, try to make one for yourself. These are the color options in which I have made this cup coaster. You can change the sequence of the color to make a set of coaster or the pot holder. Thank you so much.